Welcome students, welcome to Thermal Engineering session.
In this session, Rankine we are going cycle. To see about the ideal
it
Rankine
named
cycle.
After William John Macrin Rankine, a Scottish polymath and Glasgow University professor. The Rankine cycle is a model used to predict the performance of steam turbine. The Rankine cycle is an idealized thermodynamic cycle of a heat engine that converts heat into mechanical work while undergoing phase change. It is an idealized cycle in which friction losses in each of the four components are neglected. The heat is supplied externally to a closed loop, which usually uses water as the working fluid. This is how the ideal Rankine cycle looks like. So we can see there what are the elements which we are using for the ideal Rankine cycle. The first one is the boiler. So this is the boiler. In boiler, the working fluid, that is water, receives heat by combustion of fuel and is converted into steam. The next comes the feed pump. So this is the feed pump. The feed pump feeds the condensate from hot well to boiler at boiler pressure. The next comes the steam turbine. So in steam turbine, the steam from the boiler pressure expands to deliver work of expansion. And then comes the condenser. In condenser, the exhaust steam from the turbine gives heat to cooling water and completely condenses to water.
Let us see what are the four processes in the Rankine cycle. These states are identified by numbers in the above TS diagram. So process 1 to 2. So process 1 to 2 is, it is the exit of the condenser and the inlet of the boiler. Okay, which is done by the pump. The working fluid is pumped from low to high pressure. As the fluid is a liquid, at this stage the pump requires little input energy. So this is the process 1 to 2, which is from increasing the low pressure. The fluid is pumped from low pressure to high pressure, that is from the condensate and the into the boiler. Process 2 to 3, the high pressure liquid enters the boiler where it is heated at constant pressure by an external heat source to become a dry saturated vapor. From process 2 to 3, it is from the boiler inlet to the boiler outlet, where the fluid gets heat absorbed from the flue gases, so that the liquid becomes a vapor form. Liquid is converted into vapor form. Here the latent heat changes is occurring, so that the phase get changes from the liquid state to the vapor state, and that vapor state also in the form of a dry saturated, or it may be in the form of a superheated form. Now from the process 3 to 4, the dry saturated vapor expands through a turbine and it's generating power, which is coupled with the turbine. So this decreases the temperature and the pressure of the vapor, and some condensation may occur. So this is from the process 3 to 4. It is the turbine work is happening, so that here the expansion process will happen. During this expansion process, the pressure and the temperature will get decreased. Now the process 4 to 1. The wet vapor then enters a condenser where it is condensed at a constant pressure to become a saturated liquid. So here also latent heat is working, so that we are condensing this vapor form into a liquid form. So in an ideal Rankine cycle, the pump and turbine would be isentropic, that is the pump and turbine would generate no entropy and hence maximize the net work output. the process 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 would be represented by vertical lines on the TS diagram and more closely resemble that of the Carnot cycle. This process 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 will be isentropic. That means completely its entropy will be constant. Now let us see the Rankine cycle with the layout and along with the temperature entropy graph. Okay. Now we see the process 1 to 2. So this process 1 to 2 is from the condenser outlet and to the boiler inlet. Okay, this is the pump work process. We'll see the pump work process in the graph. So here it is. Okay. So in this, the process 1 to 2. Can you see this process 1 to 2? The line is increasing. And then now let's see the process 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. And 2 to 3 is the boiler process where the heat is added to the liquid so that the liquid become vapor form or the trisaturated form. Okay, so from process 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. Now we'll see in the graph how it is increasing. You can see from 1 to 2 and from 2 to 3. Okay. Now I'll explain this process 1 to 2. This is a saturated liquid line and this is a saturated vapor line. And in between this is a wet region. Okay, but the point 1 and 2 is in the liquid region because the exit of the condenser will be in the pure liquid format. And it may contain some vapor particles also. But when feed water is also added along with this condensate, it will become completely liquid. That is in the point 2. So the point 2 is in completely liquid state. And at also in the low temperature region. And from 1 to 2, a little pressure is increasing. Okay, so for 1 to 2, there is a slight changes in the pressure increasing. And from 2 to 3, completely temperature is getting increasing. Okay, and from 2 to 3. So from 2, it slightly go to this saturation liquid line. And after that, a particular point, after it reaches a boiling temperature, it goes into the wet region. And slightly the vaporization starts and completely touches the dry saturated point. That is, the point 3 represents the complete dry saturated steam. And the third option is the 3 to 4 process. It is the turbine work from 3 to 4. So during this turbine work, what are the things happen? There is an expansion work is happened. High pressure is getting reduced to low pressure. While the high pressure steam enters into the turbine and it rotates the turbine blade so that the turbine or mechanical work outputs comes from the turbine and so that it reduces the input pressure of the steam so that the pressure get reduces and simultaneously the temperature also get reduces and most probably it will having some condensation also happen so that the exit point of the turbine will be in the form of the mixture form. So it comes with the mixture of dry vapor and the mixture of moisture also. Okay, so from 3 to 4, since it is an isentropic process, so 3 to 4 it is an isentropic process, the line will be straight or more approximately equal to straight line. So from 3 to 4 process, so 3 is a complete dry saturated process point and 4 it is a exit of the turbine. Exit of the turbine means the position of the point 4 will be in the form of mixture position because in turbine the pressure and temperature get reduced so that some particles may get condensate so that some vapor particles along with the water particles also inside present in the point number 4 and 4 to 1 it is a condensation process so that it is completely become the 100% saturated liquid. So 4 to 1 is a condensation process. The vapor is completely converted into saturated liquid. This is 4 to 1.
Now, let's see what are the positions and how heat is added and what are the calculation of heat added, heat rejection, efficiency in this line. So, heat added in the boiler. Where is the heat added in the boiler? The heat added in the boiler is in between point 2 and 3. Okay, that is point 2 is here and point 3 is here. So, in this thermal and in this steam applications, in steam power plant, the heat is calculated in the form of the enthalpy, because enthalpy is termed as the total heat energy stored in the system. Okay, so the heat energy is calculated in form of the enthalpy. Okay, so Q input, that is heat input, is in between the point 3 and point 2. So point 3 and 2 we refer in the in terms of enthalpy, H3 and H2, and the heat rejected in the condenser. Here in condenser, the heat is rejected, where in between 4 and 1. So this also represented in enthalpy, that is H4 minus H1. Here in heat added, H3 minus H2, because the higher temperature in the point 3 and higher low temperature in the point 2. So that higher enthalpy is in point 3 and lower enthalpy is in point 2. And why we are referring F means F reference fluid. It means the point 2 is in the fluid position, that is in the liquid position. It is not in the gas. Okay. And the same time, point H4 minus H1F. So H4 is in the wet region, but H1 is in the complete saturated liquid line. So that one is represented in terms of 1F. You can see H3, it is in the dry saturated position, and H2F, it is completely in the liquid region, and H4, it is in the wet region. Wet region means it is a mixed region, both vapor and liquid, and this one is in the, and H1F is in the pure liquid, saturated liquid line. Now we calculate the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. We know that heat added in boiler is Q1 is equal to H3 minus H2F, and heat rejected in condenser is equal to H4 minus H1F. So that efficiency of Rankine cycle is equal to Q in, that is heat added minus heat rejected divided by heat added, that is Q in minus Q out divided by Q in. The Q represents heat. So that we can write as H3 minus H2F minus H4 minus H1F divided by H3 minus H2F. We can rearrange the numerator like this. Bring this minus H2F here and bring this H4 here. If we rewrite this also, there is no changes, because this minus H2F, if you bring it here, outside is minus. If you bring the again minus inside, it will get the minus H2F. Okay. After rewriting this, we'll get H3 minus H4 minus of H2F minus H1F divided by H3 minus H2F. So the bottommost line, H3 minus H2F, this can be rewrite as H3 minus H1F minus of H2F minus H1F. So this is the final representation we are getting. H3 minus H4 minus of H2F minus H1F divided by H3 minus H1F minus of H2F minus H1F. Okay. So this is how the Rankine cycle will get. So this is the final Rankine cycle we are receiving. And these two are the actual pump work in the Rankine cycle. These two, H2F minus H1F, is the actual pump work which is in the graph, in which is in the Rankine cycle. So final answer is we get a Rankine cycle efficiency equal to H3 minus H4 minus pump work divided by H3 minus H1F minus pump work. So this throughout the Rankine cycle, as compared to turbine work, pump work is very small. When compared to the turbine work, pump work is very small. It is negligible. So it can be neglected. It will not create a much difference even if it is there in the equation or not. So it is neglected. So we'll get the final Rankine cycle will be H3 minus H4 divided by H3 minus H1F. The efficiency of the Rankine cycle can also be defined as follows. So efficiency of the Rankine cycle is equal to net work done by heat supplied. So that is net work done divided by heat supplied, W net divided by Q in. The heat added in boiler, which is represented by Q in, which is equal to H3 minus H2F. The net work done, which is represented by W net, which is equal to WT minus WP. That is the turbine work minus pump work. Turbine work is represented by H3 minus H4 minus of H2F minus H1F. Therefore, the Rankine cycle is represented by H3 minus H4 minus of H2F minus H1F divided by H3 minus H2F. So this also is the one form of the efficiency of Rankine cycle. So thank you, students. Thank you for watching this. See you in the next class.